This company's flock includes males, females, and androgynous models like this one. This more elaborate male is inspired by the loon on Canada's $1 coin. To make them, these craftsmen use eastern white pine because it's easy to carve and has a nice grain. First, a machine shapes a 5 centimeter thick slab. They cut the slab lengthwise. They'll use 4 to 6 of these smaller pieces to make most of the duck's body. The birds range in size, from baby ducks just 10 centimeters long to Canada geese at more than half a meter long. A craftsman now applies a generous amount of carpenter's glue to one side of the wood. Using a lot ensures a strong bond and prevents splitting later on. The pieces then go into what's called a wood clamp. He tightens a vise, squeezing them together. It takes about 2 hours for the pieces to bond properly. Then he'll shave away the excess glue and even up the surfaces. Once that's done, they run the block over what's called a joiner. A roller with 3 blades shaves about 2 centimeters from what will become the top and bottom of the duck. Each model has 3 wooden patterns, for the top, the bottom, and the profile. Here, a worker traces the outline of the bird's profile in pencil on the wood. Since this is a small model, he'll make 2 birds with 1 block. Using a bandsaw, he trims along the trace line. This company recycles the cutoffs into fireplace kindling and shavings for farm stables. Next, he uses another pattern to create the top of the bird. These patterns provide only the general shape of a particular model. The craftsman will later carve the details using small electric tools and by hand. Now he sands the wood with a pneumatic drum sander, a tube of pressurized air with sandpaper stretched over it. He uses higher pressure for sharper curves, lower pressure for softer edges. To sculpt the bird's plumage, the craftsman uses this band sander, whose rounded edge presses sandpaper into the wood. Here he makes 3 long grooves, one on top and one on each side of the duck. The head's made from a different piece of wood than the body. Here he sands down the piece to smooth out the curves. Using various shaping tools and the band sander, he sculpts the bird's head and bill area, then the underside and rear end of this waddling duck. He also carves depressions for eye sockets to come later. Here, he puts glue on the neck to attach it to the rest of the body. Using a nail gun, he reinforces the area with 2 nails on each side. To hide the nails and smooth out the neck, the craftsman uses wood putty. Once it dries, he'll sand it smooth. Next, he tints the duck bill using an orange wood stain. Then a forest green stain to tint the head and neck areas. Males have colorful feathers to better attract mates. Females have more neutral colors to blend into their surroundings and protect their ducklings. The craftsman covers the duck's lower body with a clear wood stain. This way, the natural grain of the wood shows through. The front gets a clear but darker stain to mark the chest. And darker stain also highlights the plumage in the long grooves. Then some green accents for the feathers on the sides in the back. Next, 2 coats of white paint to mark the duck's collar. Then he glues plastic eyes in the eye sockets. The irises are black, brown, or red, depending on the model. He then sprays on a protective water-based varnish and elevates the duck on nails so that the underside will dry along with the rest. Finally, the craftsman rubs the entire carving in wood wax. This makes the varnish appear uneven in places, giving the duck a worn antique finish, like he's been around the pond a few times. The prices of wooden ducks vary according to size and detail. $500 will buy you this magnificent Canada goose with wings stretched and ready for a graceful landing.